Santo Padre dà ora inizio all'udienza generale introducendola con il segno della croce e il saluto liturgico. Disponiamoci ad accogliere la sua parola e a ricevere la sua benedizione.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
Dal Vangelo di San Marco. Quando fu in casa, Gesù, sedutosi, chiamò i dodici e disse loro: «Se uno vuole essere il primo, sia l'ultimo di tutti e il servitore di tutti». E preso un bambino, lo pose in mezzo a loro e abbracciandolo disse loro: «Chi accoglie uno solo di questi bambini nel mio nome, accoglie me. E chi accoglie me, non accoglie me, ma colui che mi ha mandato». È parola di Dio.
de l'Évangile selon saint Marc. Une fois à la maison, s'étant assis, Jésus appela les 12 et leur dit : Si quelqu'un veut être le premier, qu'il soit le dernier de tous et le serviteur de tous. Prenant alors un enfant, il le plaça au milieu d'eux, l'embrassa et leur dit : Quiconque accueille en mon nom un enfant comme celui-ci, c'est moi qui l'accueille. Et celui qui m'accueille, ce n'est pas moi qui l'accueille, mais celui qui m'a envoyé. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the Gospel according to Saint Mark. At that time, when Jesus was in the house, he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Then he took a little child and put it among them. Taking it in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Evangelium nach Markus. Als Jesus im Haus war, da setzte er sich, rief die 12 und sagte zu ihnen: Wer der Erste sein will, soll der Letzte von allen und der Diener aller sein. Und er stellte ein Kind in ihre Mitte, nahm es in seine Arme und sagte zu ihnen: Wer ein solches Kind in meinem Namen aufnimmt, der nimmt mich auf. Und wer mich aufnimmt, der nimmt nicht nur mich auf, sondern den, der mich gesandt hat. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del Santo Evangelio según San Marcos. Una vez que estuvieron en la casa, Jesús, sentándose, llamó a los 12 y les dijo: El que quiere ser el primero debe hacerse el último de todos y el servidor de todos. Después, tomando a un niño, lo puso en medio de ellos y, abrazándolo, les dijo: El que recibe a uno de estos pequeños en mi nombre, me recibe a mí. Y el que me recibe, no es a mí al que recibe, sino a aquel que me ha enviado. Palabra del Señor.
Leitura do Evangelho de São Marcos. Quando estavam em casa, Jesus, sentando-se, chamou os 12 e disse-lhes: Se alguém quiser ser o primeiro, há de ser o último de todos e o servo de todos. E tomando um menino, colocou-o no meio deles, abraçou-o e disse-lhes: Quem receber um destes meninos em meu nome, é a mim que recebe. E quem me receber, não me recebe a mim, mas àquele que me enviou. Palavra da Salvação.
من إنجيل ربنا يسوع المسيح للقديس مرقس. لما دخل البيت جلس يسوع ودعا الاثني عشر وقال لهم: من أراد أن يكون أول القوم فليكن آخرهم جميعا وخادمهم. ثم أخذ بيد طفل فأقامه بينهم وضمه إلى صدره وقال لهم: من قبل واحدا من أمثال هؤلاء الأطفال إكراما لاسمي فقد قبلني أنا، ومن قبلني فلم يقبلني أنا بل الذي أرسلني. كلام الرب.
Z Ewangelii według świętego Marka. Gdy był w domu, Jezus powiedział im: jeśli kto chce być pierwszym, niech będzie ostatnim ze wszystkich i sługą wszystkich. Potem wziął dziecko, postawił je przed nimi i objąwszy je ramionami, rzekł do nich: kto przyjmie jedno z tych dzieci w imię moje, mnie przyjmuje, a kto mnie przyjmuje, nie przyjmuje mnie, lecz tego, który mnie posłał. Oto słowo Pańskie.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno. Oggi dobbiamo avere un po' di pazienza con questo caldo, no? E grazie di venire con questo caldo, questo sole. Grazie tante della visita vostra. In questa serie di catechesi sullo zelo apostolico, stiamo parlando di questo, stiamo incontrando alcune figure esemplari di uomini e donne di ogni tempo e ogni luogo che hanno dato la vita per il Vangelo. Oggi andiamo in Oceania, lontano, un continente fatto di moltissime isole, grandi e piccole. La fede in Cristo che tanti emigrati europei hanno portato in quelle terre si è presto radicata e ha prodotto frutti abbondanti. Tra questi c'è una religiosa straordinaria, Santa Mary McKillop, fondatrice delle Suore di San Giuseppe del Sacro Cuore, che ha dedicato la sua vita alla formazione intellettuale e religiosa dei poveri in Australia rurale. Mary McKillop nasce nei pressi di Melbourne da genitori emigrati in Australia dalla Scozia. Da ragazza si sentì chiamata da Dio a servirlo, a testimoniarlo, non solo con le parole, ma soprattutto con una vita trasformata dalla presenza di Dio. Come Maria Maddalena, che per prima incontrò Gesù risorto e fu mandata da lui a portare l'annuncio ai discepoli, Mary era convinta di essere lei pure inviata a diffondere la buona notizia e ad attrarre altri all'incontro col Dio vivente. Leggendo con saggezza i segni dei tempi, ella capì che per lei il modo migliore di farlo era attraverso l'educazione dei giovani, nella consapevolezza che l'educazione cattolica è una forma di evangelizzazione. È una grande forma di evangelizzazione. Così, se possiamo dire che ciascun santo ha una missione e un progetto del Padre per riflettere, incarnare in un momento determinato della storia un aspetto del Vangelo, Mary McKillop lo è stata soprattutto attraverso la fondazione di scuole. Una caratteristica essenziale del suo zelo per il Vangelo consisteva nel prendersi cura dei poveri e degli emarginati. E questo è molto importante, eh? Non nella strada della santità, anche nella strada cristiana, i poveri, gli emarginati, sono protagonisti. E non può, una persona non può andare avanti nella santità se non si dedica anche a loro, di un modo o di un altro. Ma sono la presenza del Signore, coloro che hanno bisogno dell'aiuto del Signore. Una volta ho letto una frase che mi ha colpito. Diceva così: il protagonista della storia è il mendicante. Loro sono coloro che attirano l'attenzione su questa grande ingiustizia che è la grande povertà nel mondo. Si spendono i soldi per fabbricare delle armi, no? E non per fare dei pasti. E non dimenticati, non c'è santità senché di uno o altro modo ci sia la cura per i poveri, per i bisognosi, per coloro che sono un po' al margine della società. Questo prendersi cura dei poveri e degli emarginati spingeva Mary ad andare là dove non volevano o non potevano andare. Il 19 marzo del 1866, festa di San Giuseppe, aprì la prima scuola in un piccolo sobborgo del Sud Australia. Ne seguirono tanti altri che lei o le sue consorelle fondarono nella comunità rurale in Australia e Nuova Zelanda. Ma si moltiplica, lo zelo apostolico è così, moltiplica le opere. Mary McLeod era convinta che lo scopo dell'educazione è lo sviluppo integrale. Da parte di ogni insegnante, l'educazione in effetti non consiste nel riempire la testa di idee, no, solo questo no, ma in che consiste l'educazione? Nell'accompagnare e incoraggiare gli studenti nel cammino di crescita umana, spirituale, mostrando loro quanto l'amicizia con Gesù risorto dilati il cuore e renda la vita più umana. Educare e aiutare a pensare bene, a sentire bene il linguaggio del cuore e a fare bene il linguaggio delle mani. Questa visione è pienamente attuale oggi quando sentiamo il bisogno di un patto educativo capace di unire le famiglie, le scuole e l'intera società. Lo zelo di Mary McKinlop per la diffusione del Vangelo tra i poveri la condusse anche a intraprendere diverse altre opere di carità, a partire dalla Casa della Provvidenza, aperta ad Adelaide, per accogliere anziani fanciulli abbandonati. Mary aveva molta fede nella provvidenza di Dio, era sempre fiduciosa che in qualsiasi situazione.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. In this series of catechesis on apostolic zeal, we are encountering some exemplary figures of men and women from all times and places who have given their lives for the gospel. Today, we are going to Oceania, a continent made up of many islands, large and small. The faith in Christ, which so many European emigrants brought to those lands, soon took root and bore abundant fruit. Among them was an extraordinary religious sister, Mary McKillop, foundress of the Sisters of St. Joseph of the Sacred Heart, who dedicated her life to the intellectual and religious formation of the poor in rural Australia. Mary McKillop was born near Melbourne to parents who emigrated to Australia from Scotland. As a young girl, she felt called by God to serve Him and bear witness to Him not only with words, but above all with a life transformed by God's presence. Like Mary Magdalene, who first encountered the risen Jesus and was sent by him to bring the proclamation of the disciples, Mary was convinced that she too was sent to spread the good news and attract others to an encounter with the living God. Wisely reading the signs of the times, she understood that for her, the best way to do so was through the education of the young, in the knowledge that Catholic education is a form of evangelization. In this way, if we can say that each saint is a mission planned by the Father to reflect and embody, at a specific moment in history, a certain aspect of the Gospel, then Mary MacKillop was especially so through the founding of schools. An essential characteristic of her zeal for the Gospel was caring for the poor and marginalized. This drove her to where others would not or could not go. On 19th March 1866, the feast of Saint Joseph, she opened the first school in a small suburb in South Australia. It was followed by many others that she and her sisters founded in rural communities throughout Australia and New Zealand. Mary MacKillop was convinced that the purpose of education is the integral development of the person, both as an individual and as a member of the community, and that this requires wisdom, patience, and charity on the part of every teacher. Indeed, education does not consist on filling the head with ideas, but of accompanying and encouraging students on the path of human and spiritual growth, showing them how friendship with the risen Jesus expands the heart and makes life more human. This vision is fully relevant today when we feel the need for an educational pact capable of uniting families, schools, and society as a whole. Mary MacKillop's zeal for spreading the gospel among the poor also led her to undertake a number of other charitable works, starting with the Providence House opened in Adelaide to take in the elderly and abandoned children. Mary had great faith in God's providence. She was always confident that in any situation God provides, but this did not spare her from the anxieties and difficulties arising from her apostolate, and Mary had good reason for this. She had to pay bills, negotiate with local bishops and priests, manage the schools, and look after the professional and spiritual formation of her sisters. And later, she suffered health problems. Yet, through it all, she remained calm, patiently carrying the cross that is an integral part of the mission. On one occasion, on the Feast of the Exaltation of the Cross, Mary said to one of her sisters, "My daughter, for many years I have learned the love of the cross." She did not give up in times of trial and darkness, when her joy was damped by opposition and rejection. She remained convinced that even when the Lord gave her the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, He Himself would soon answer her cry and surround her with His grace. This was the secret of her apostolic zeal. Brothers and sisters, may Saint Mary MacKillop's missionary discipleship, her creative response to the needs of the Church of her time, and her commitment to the integral formation of young people inspire all of us today, called to be a leaven of the Gospel in our rapidly changing societies. May her example and intercession support the daily work of parents, teachers, catechists, and all educators for the good of young people and for a more humane and hopeful future. Those were the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, during the catechesis of this morning. Let's continue listening to the different languages in which his teaching is being spread throughout the world.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their deep sentiments of respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose, and in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in our catechesis on apostolic zeal, we have been reflecting on the example of those men and women of every time and place who devoted their lives to the spread of the gospel. Today, we turn to the distant continent of Oceania and the witness of St. Mary MacKillop, a great educator and the foundress of the Sisters of St. Joseph of the Sacred Heart. The daughter of Scottish immigrants, Mary discerned the great need for schooling among the children of the poverty-stricken rural communities of Australia. Together with the sisters of her congregation, she founded numerous schools throughout the country to care for the spiritual and human formation of the young. Mary's great trust in God's providence and the power of the cross sustained her amid the inevitable trials she faced in her growing apostolate. As we give thanks for the enduring fruitfulness of her zeal for the gospel, let us pray that her creative response to the needs of the church of her time will inspire the efforts of today's parents, catechists, and educators as they strive to introduce young people to the beauty of friendship with Jesus and prepare them to be a leaven of the gospel in today's rapidly changing society. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese, specialmente ai gruppi provenienti da Inghilterra, Australia, Palestina, Filippini, Canada e Stati Uniti. Su tutti voi e sulle vostre famiglie invoco la gioia e la pace del Signore nostro Cristo Gesù. Dio benedica.
I extend a warm welcome to the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors taking part in today's audience, especially the groups from England, Australia, Palestine, the Philippines, Canada, and the United States of America. Upon you and your families, I invoke the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you all.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebets in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, eine weitere große Zeugin apostolischen Eifers ist die heilige Mary MacKillop, die Gründerin der Schwestern des heiligen Josef vom Heiligsten Herzen. Bereits in jungen Jahren stand für sie fest, dass sie den Glauben nicht nur mit Worten verkünden wollte, sondern durch ein in der Gegenwart Gottes verwandeltes Leben. In einer katholischen Erziehung sah sie eine wichtige Form der Glaubensvermittlung. Und so gründete sie Schulen in Australien sowie Neuseeland und widmete dabei den Armen und Außenseitern der Gesellschaft besondere Aufmerksamkeit. Sie verfolgte in der Erziehung einen ganzheitlichen Ansatz, der den Menschen sowohl als Individuum wie auch als Glied einer Gemeinschaft in den Blick nimmt. Dementsprechend war Erziehung für sie stets mehr als nur Wissensvermittlung. Es ging ihr um eine weise, geduldige und liebevolle Begleitung sowie Ermutigung der Heranwachsenden auf ihrem Weg menschlichen und geistlichen Wachstums. Viele fanden so zu einer lebendigen Beziehung mit dem Auferstandenen, die das Herz weit und das Leben menschlicher macht. Möge die heilige Mary MacKillop allen, die in der Ausbildung und Erziehung tätig sind, ein leuchtendes Vorbild sein. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Saluto del cuore i pellegrini di lingua tedesca. Occasione della solennità dei Santi Apostoli Pietro e Paolo, che celebriamo domani, vorrei invitare tutti ad approfondire la propria fede e, imitando il loro esempio, ad annunciare il Vangelo ovunque con le parole e con le opere. Per favore, ricordatevi anche di pregare per il successore di Pietro. Grazie.
Der Heilige Vater sagte: Herzlich grüße ich die Pilger deutscher Sprache. Zum Hochfest der heiligen Apostel Petrus und Paulus, das wir morgen begehen, möchte ich alle einladen, den eigenen Glauben zu vertiefen und ihrem Beispiel folgend überall das Evangelium zu verkünden, mit Worten und Taten. Bitte denkt auch daran, für den Nachfolger Petri zu beten. Danke.
Santo Padre, los visitantes y peregrinos de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, su Santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica, que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, dedicamos esta catequesis sobre el celo apostólico a una religiosa australiana, Santa María MacKillop, fundadora de las Hermanas de San José del Sagrado Corazón. Ella, como María Magdalena, se encontró con Jesús resucitado y se sintió impulsada a difundir a todos la buena noticia. Su celo apostólico la llevó a realizar numerosas obras de caridad, como la fundación de escuelas y hogares para los más necesitados, sobre todo en las zonas más rurales. Podemos decir que el apostolado que realizó María McClellan, basado principalmente en acompañar a las personas en su crecimiento humano y espiritual, sigue siendo plenamente actual, ya que vemos la necesidad de un pacto educativo que una a la familia, las escuelas y a toda la sociedad. Sabemos que esto no es nada fácil. También nuestra santa tuvo que afrontar diversos problemas y diversas dificultades, pero su testimonio de vida nos enseña a confiar en la providencia de Dios y en la fuerza de la gracia, especialmente en los momentos de cruz y oscuridad. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua española, en particular a los alumnos de los institutos diocesanos de Gran Canaria, España. Pidamos al Señor, por intercesión de Santa María McClellan y todos los santos y santas que se dedicaron a la educación, que sostenga el trabajo cotidiano de los padres y de los maestros, de los catequistas y formadores por el bien de la juventud y en vistas a un futuro de paz y fraternidad. Que Jesús los bendiga y la Virgen Santa los cuide. Muchas gracias.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade e rezam por todas as intenções do seu Ministério Apostólico Universal. No final desta audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar. No presente ciclo de catequeses sobre o zelo apostólico, temos refletido acerca de algumas figuras exemplares de homens e mulheres que deram a sua vida pelo Evangelho. Hoje, vamos buscar à Oceania o testemunho extraordinário de Santa Mary Maciope, fundadora das Irmãs de São José do Sagrado Coração. A sua obra corresponde ao projeto que Deus tinha para ela, dar visibilidade a um aspecto do Evangelho num determinado momento da história. Santa Mary Maciope, atenta aos sinais dos tempos, compreendeu que o modo melhor de evangelizar o seu mundo passava pela educação dos jovens, principalmente dos jovens pobres que habitavam em periferias onde mais ninguém queria ou podia ir. A 19 de março de 1866, dia de São José, abriu a primeira escola num pequeno subúrbio de Pénula, no sul da Austrália. Seguiram-se depois muitas outras, nas quais os professores eram convidados a acompanhar e encorajar estudantes rumo a um desenvolvimento integral da sua pessoa, isto é, sem esquecer a dimensão espiritual. Na verdade, a amizade com Jesus dilata os corações e torna a vida mais humana. E isto mesmo pode comprovar-se no acolhimento que a própria Mary Maciope dispensava às crianças e aos idosos abandonados. Ainda que tal atividade lhe custasse inúmeras canseiras e dificuldades económicas, o segredo foi sempre a fé na providência. Era em Deus que ela encontrava tranquilidade, readquiria o entusiasmo e reavivava a alegria. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Cari fratelli di lingua portoghese, benvenuti. Saluto in modo speciale quanti vengano da Colares in Portogallo, da Campo Limpio e Recife in Brasile. Mi trovate a Roma, proprio nell'imminenza della festa dei Santi Pietro e Paolo, le cui spoglie si possono venerare in questa città. Auspico che il vostro pellegrinaggio confermi nel cuore di ciascuno il desiderio di evangelizzare e che la vostra vita trasfigurata da Gesù sia un motivo di crescita e di gioia per tutti. Dio vi benedica.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras. Queridos fiéis de língua portuguesa, sede bem-vindos. Saúdo de modo especial todos aqueles que vêm de Colares, em Portugal, de Campo Limpo e de Recife, no Brasil. Encontrais-vos em Roma, precisamente na iminência da festa de São Pedro e São Paulo, cujas relíquias se podem venerar nesta cidade. Espero que a vossa peregrinação confirme no coração de cada um o desejo de evangelizar e que a vossa vida transfigurada por Jesus seja para todos motivo de crescimento e alegria. Deus vos abençoe.
أيها الأب الأقدس، يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معاً صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة، وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس.
And we hear the various greetings in various languages, and right now we're listening to the Arabic language summary of Pope Francis's catechesis this morning at the Wednesday General Audience. The Pope focused his catechesis, which is a continuation of his series on apostolic zeal. This week we went to Oceania, especially Australia, where St. Mary MacKillop was carried out her ministry in the late 1800s and early 1900s. فكانت تعلن البشرى السارة وتجذب الناس للقاء الله وأدركت أن أفضل طريقة للقيام بذلك هي من خلال تربية الشباب وهي واعية أن التربية الكاثوليكية هي شكل من أشكال البشارة بالإنجيل كانت الميزة الأساسية لغيرتها على الإنجيل تقوم بالاهتمام بالفقراء والمهمشين فذهبت إلى حيث لم يرد غيرها أن يذهب. And as we continue with this with the catechesis in Arabic. We also greet the many listeners who are joining us today from various radio stations and TV networks, including Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmarashan TV, EWTN TV, UCTV, Uganda Catholic Television, Catholic TV, and Luminous Radio in India. And we apologize also because earlier we had some technical difficulties and now we have resolved them, and so we'll be continuing with our translation and commentary of this Wednesday general audience here in St. Peter's Square. الصليب الذي هو جزء لا يتجزأ من الرسالة والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba, particolare quelli provenienti nella parrocchia Nostra Signora dei Sette Dolori nel villaggio di Abud in Palestina. Seguendo l'esempio di Santa Mary McLillop, siamo chiamati a prenderci cura sempre della formazione umana, spirituale, scientifica per dei giovani, per il loro bene e per un futuro migliore, più umano e pieno di speranza. Signore benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
أحيي المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية.
I greet the faithful in the Arabic language, the Arabic language speaking faithful, and especially those who come from the parish of Our Lady of the Seven Pains in the village of Abud in Palestine. Following the example of St. Mary McKillop, we are called to take care always of human formation and spiritual and scientific formation of the young people, especially for their good and for a better future, one that is more human and full of hope. May the Lord bless you and protect you from every evil. And now, the Polish language greetings to the Holy Father and the summary in Polish.
Obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. W cyklu katechez o gorliwości...
So just to recap a little bit about St. Mary McKillop. She lived from 1842 to 1909. She was born near Melbourne to Scottish immigrants to Australia. But she felt called from a very young age, as we heard from Pope Francis, to serve God in a special way. And she believed that Catholic education was a very important tool and means for communicating the faith and to spread the gospel to the people of her times. And she focused especially on the poor and in rural areas, and as well as the Aboriginal peoples of Australia. And she founded the Sisters of St. Joseph of the Sacred Heart. As Pope Francis said, it's very important that we, as a church, focus on educating and accompanying the people who are on the margins of society. And as St. Mary felt pushed to go where others refused to go or were even unable to go. And she opened her first school on the Feast of St. Joseph in 1866 in southern Australia. And this was followed by many others in rural communities in other parts of Australia, as well as in New Zealand. Pope Francis highlighted that education should always promote the integral development of the person, both as an individual and as a member of the community. This, he said, requires wisdom, patience, and charity on the part of every teacher. Anyone who's taught others or raised children knows that it's that is, all of these three traits are very necessary as we accompany others. Education, he said, consists not in filling heads with ideas, but is more about accompanying and encouraging students along their path of human and spiritual growth. And we, by doing this, we show them that friendship with the risen Christ opens our hearts and makes our lives more human. And Pope Francis greets the Polish-speaking faithful.
E ogni giorno ricevo nel mio ministero apostolico. Vi auguro buone vacanze, chiedendovi di non trascurare il Signore e la pratica delle opere di misericordia in questo periodo. Seguendo l'esempio di Santa Maria Macchillo, siete testimonianza concreta del Vangelo per coloro che soffrono per la povertà e la guerra in Ucraina. Vi benedico di cuore.
Pope Francis said, I cordially greet the Polish pilgrims. I thank you for your prayerful support that I felt during my stay in hospital recently and every day that I receive in my apostolic ministry. I wish you many happy vacation and ask you not to neglect the Lord and the practice of works of mercy during these summer months. Following the example of St. Mary Macilloch, be a concrete witness of the gospel to those who suffer from poverty and war in Ukraine. I bless you, he said, from the bottom of my heart. Pope Francis, referring there to his recent stay in hospital, he went on June 7th for a surgery on an abdominal hernia, and he stayed in hospital for 9 days. And this is the first audience after that hospitalization. And now we hear the Italian language greetings, reminding that at the end of this audience we will pray the Our Father in Latin, and Pope Francis will express his, offer his apostolic blessing.
Domenica scorsa è stata beatificata Madre Elisa Martinez presso
last week
presso il santuario di Santa Maria di Leuca, che dà nome alla congregazione da lei fondata. Questo le suore sono lì. È bello e possiamo fare nostro il suo proposito.
Pope Francis says that last Sunday the Mother Elisa Martinez was beatified at the sanctuary of St. Mary of Leuca, and she offers her name to the congregation founded by her. He said it's beautiful to and important to make our own her desire, which is to expand our heart, to embrace all of creatures who are spread throughout every angle and corner of the earth, especially those who are most in need and marginalized. And let us offer a round of applause for the new blessed. I also cordially greet the pilgrims of Italian language, Italian-speaking pilgrims, especially religious of the Congregation of the Resurrection, the Sons of St. Mary Immaculate, the Sisters of the Little Shepherd, the Missionary Servants of the Holy Sacrament, and the Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, and the Sisters of Charity of Our Lady of Good and of Perpetual Help, who are all celebrating their own general chapters. I'm happy to I offer a special greeting to young people, the sick, the elderly, and new spouses. Tomorrow we will celebrate the Solemnity of Saints Peter and Paul, the example and protection of these two apostles. May their example sustain each of us in our own following of Christ. And to them we entrust the beloved people of Ukraine, because And may we, there's much suffering going on there, may there soon be peace in those lands. I offer everyone my blessing. Now we pray the Our Father.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex aut nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
And we hear the applause, thanking Pope Francis for this general audience, which is the first since his hospitalization earlier this month, and the last before this summer break. There will be no general audiences during this month of July, as is customary for Pope Francis, who usually takes this month to relax and take a little bit more time for himself, in his, even though he continues his ministry. And this ends the live stream broadcast of Pope Francis's Wednesday General Audience from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican. We invite you to join us again tomorrow morning for the Mass on the Feast of Saints Peter and Paul. Please visit our Vatican News web portal, our Facebook page, Instagram account, and Twitter feeds, and as well as our YouTube account, for coverage of today's General Audience, as well as other Vatican and world news. My name is Devin Watkins, and it's been a pleasure to provide the English language text for you. We also thank Father Felipe Herrera, who helped us out earlier with the catechesis and translation of his Pope's catechesis. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible, and to all of you for joining us. Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ.